What's poppin'? Exactly. And grandest of mornings all, I hope wellness encompasses all of us on this momentous occasion. I would like to initiate this speech with gratefulness to my family here in the States, in Arizona, and in Missouri. Like, you know, we got people all over the place. And abroad, I have family overseas. I would like to thank them all for their support, for offering me nourishment and apt resistance for growth as I commenced my academic journey and have brought this era to an end. To my friends, thank you for pouring into me in ways often unbeknownst to you, to my teachers, for going to all the lengths to ensure my safety, my wellness, and growth academically and personally. Some giving a smile, a sticker, some snacks, book recommendations, a conversation or two, guidance, a word of encouragement, some going so far as to cut up a tree to create an award that I will cherish forever. If you know, you know. I love you all more than we could possibly quantify. To my mentors and inspirations, Dr. Didika Boko, Dr. Tenille Presley, Dr. Adeolu Ilesami, Auntie Emmy, Sophia, Mimi, Grandma, aka my first friend, Miss McDowell, Miss Mara, Mr. Barton, Dr. Olayinka Akiola, and Dr. Modupeola Akiola, my parents, in no particular order, thank you for embodying my dreams in some way, shape, or form, and equipping me with the tools I need, not only to achieve them, but to move forward and embody someone else's dreams, and to make them feel that they are attainable as you've done me. I'd like to thank the universe for encompassing us all, and God for holding it all together according to his plan. To my classmates, thank you so much, because a lot of you will talk about how proud you are of me and how awesome I am, etc., etc. And I can only say that I am proud to make such legendary people proud. I'm so proud that I could share these 4 years with you in some way, shape, or form, in some capacity. I'm so proud of all of us, because, like, just bask in it. Look at us, we have our regalia on. All of us looking so nice. I'm proud of all of us, and I'm proud that I have the privilege to make an impact on your lives. And then this is the part where I shower you with all the well wishes and pride. I say, we did it. Go trees! I'm excited for our future, or something like that. But honestly, I really can't. Why? Well, A, I might break down crying. We don't want that. B, because it's quite cliche. And C, because it wouldn't be entirely genuine. I look at the vast world we're about to diffuse into, and frankly, I'm scared. I see how it cries out for solutions to its problems and remedy for the various sicknesses it faces. Hunger, intolerance, corruption, hatred, racism, apathy, disease, unspeakable harm against too many communities. All of these things plague the lives of us and the people around us. Now, I'm not asking us to go and change the world, though I don't doubt our capabilities to do so. I am asking, or rather begging, us to practice a singular thing in our individual lives as new graduates and new people. A poet called Rumi once said, "Yesterday, I was clever, so I wanted to change the world. Today, I am wise, so I'm changing myself. This is all I ask. I want us to feel our heartbeats, a universal sign of blood pumping nutrients to our organs, a function of life. As we live, as we interact with others, build relationships old and new, as we meet ourselves over and over again, as we pursue whatever catches our passion, I implore us to stay aware of that heartbeat, in not only us, but in those around us. Respect the humanity of others as you wish for yours to be respected. So the next time we catch ourselves all too ready to resign others into a box of any kind, weaponize our biases against our fellow human beings, justify harm done to others using their deeds, or quiet the cries for life from those facing preventable death daily, remember your heartbeat and honor the horrendous fact that life itself is a privilege many are often not afforded. Let your heart beat for them as it beats for you." This next section is for 3 quotes that resonated with me and their applications to us. The first one, when you're secure in who you are, want to be, you can do anything you want as that person. I said that one. I know many of us explored our identities further throughout the course of our high school careers, and it's with pride that I look out on all of your beautiful masked faces at the beautiful people we have all become. I can only hope that you find freedom and love in your identity as I have in mine. And may you be surrounded by people who uplift you in every stage of your life. May we be uplifting to those we love in every stage of their lives as well. Number two, if you expect perfection soon, you're gonna burn out. Can anyone guess who said that? It was Barton, LOL. I implore all of us to discover ourselves and know ourselves, every part. Know your limits not only to exceed them, but to find rest in knowing your greatness, your logic, and compassion.